And every now and then I get some sucker to agree to let me interview them. And this is, there's no exception to this. I talked them into it. And this is going to be fun. We're going to have fun. We're going to talk about cottage food and how you can make money, profit, okay, from home. I've shared with you the school teacher that does it. I've shared with you probably 100 people over the last year. COVID really inspired this. I've been teaching this for years about how you make money from home without a hot dog cart. Now, obviously, I want you to buy 6 or 7 hot dog carts, but even if you can't afford that and you don't know what to do and COVID's stopping you or whatever it is, and you need to make money from home, I promise you there is a way to make real money, real incomes, not like, oh, I like that. That's going to buy me a new pair of shoes in 3 months. I'm talking real income. So I want to bring in Jim and Dee. Dee's Delicious Cookies. And I'm going to bring them in real quick. I've already put a link on the screen. And that link will get you over to their eBay, which I'm going to tell you about later. But anyway, welcome to the show, Jim and Dee.
Well, thank you, Ben. We're happy to be here. Thank you for listening to this.
This is fun. And I got lucky because you see what I have? I have official. Because you know what? I don't just say, hey, these are delicious cookies. I got to eat them because they sent them to me. They sent more than I should eat, more than my doctor would tell me to eat. But I'm going to eat them anyway. Just because I think once you have milk with it, especially whole milk, it counterbalances the carbs, so it doesn't count.
No, don't. You're good.
As long as you only do like 3 Ziploc bags a day, I think you're safe. So anyway, I want to ask y'all some questions. You're in Arizona, right?
Yes.
Okay. And y'all let's do this. Let's start with telling everyone that's watching and listening. And I know I have chats going. I can't see it for whatever reason. Ain't nothing showing up on my end. But I knew there would be some kind of problems. I just was hoping it wasn't the chat. But I'll figure it out while y'all explain this. Would y'all please explain how this came to be? How did you even get into this type of thing?
Go ahead.
Well, this is something I've been doing pretty much all my life. This is a family recipe. And you know, with COVID, everything that's happened, everybody kind of has to reinvent themselves at this time.
Right.
People have lost jobs, so on and so forth. And you got to have that income coming in. So with this, it was one of those situations where we literally watched one of your videos that took us to this. And I said, you know what? I can do this. This is something that I know people love. I have people coming from all over asking me for them. So I said, finally, I'm going to go ahead and ship these. I'm going to sell these local. I'm going to do all of it. And that's really how it came about. And I hate what COVID's done for the world, but at the same time, it does make you sit back and rethink how you got to live your lives and what you got to do to make an income.
Yeah, true. And I mean, we've been involved in the vending business for a couple of years. Actually bought a hot dog cart from you a couple of years ago. And, you know, we really enjoyed that. Some family things happened and, you know, we're not doing that now, but we were like, I would eat her cookies over the last 10 years, and my son and my brother, they eat like way more than we sent you. And you know, it got to the point I said, we should sell these. And lo and behold, you know, we're doing it. I'm a delivery boy now.
Yes, he is. He's good.
I deliver. I deliver, and the smiles on their faces. And then before I get back home, she's got a text message. These are so delicious. We'll be ordering again. Thank you.
Because my daughter is a vegan.
Oh,
so
I'm
thought,
sorry.
Let's try the vegan. I know, but let's try it. Let's see how it is. And oh my God, you can't even tell the difference. I had no clue. And he's my biggest critic. So
I told her the vegan, and I said, those aren't going to work. Don't ruin the recipe. I mean, why you got to ruin the recipe?
So you were, that opens up a whole nother, base of customers. Because I have a daughter. It took 7 daughters to get 1 vegan. But, and I don't know if she's the one we dropped twice, but it could be. But she is. She's a vegan. She lives in Nashville, Tennessee. And I learned how to make yeast rolls vegan, and I learned how to make vegan pancakes.
Nice.
Perfect. You're so, a good daddy.
Yeah.
If that's what you're into, that's okay. You know, we'll make them.
Right.
You know?
I'm with you. So once you... I know you're brand new at this, right? You've been in this how long with the cookies?
1 week. 1 week.
1 week. All together total, if you add them all up, 1 week.
For sales.
So what has been, tell me the process of that week, how long it took you to get started, okay? Once you decided, hey, I'm going to do this. This looks crazy enough. We're going to try it. How much bourbon are we going to have to drink to get this going? And then what steps you took to make it all happen?
Well, you want me to answer that?
Yeah, and one of those conversations started with bourbon.
Yeah. Well, I actually, we were trying to look for ideas again, how to get into the food business. But I wanted it to be more simplified, you know, we're doing it out of our house, and we're doing it legally. And how I got started, though, is I came across, you were doing a video, the mini donut video.
Yeah. Yeah.
With Bob.
Yeah.
So I watched that, and you're doing your thing, and you put the donuts in the machine, and I'm watching you, and I enjoy watching you. I actually have watched thousands of hours of video of Ben. I don't have a life, but I enjoy myself. So anyway, I got done watching that video, and I started thinking about her cookies, and Ben's always good about giving people knowledge and helping people. That's what I like about Ben. I always have. Ben, I've always liked you for that. And
thank you.
And you really helped us with the hot dog business. I took everything I learned from that. I did all the licensing, everything I was supposed to do. And I was driven. And, you know, I'm driven with this now, and so is she. And the other course that led me to that, I'm trying to think of it. Oh, after the donut one,
yeah,
I watched your home baking profit course thing, and it helped me, because then I got on with the state of Arizona for cottage laws, and you know, it pulls up on Google. Well, you go to the government website for Arizona cottage laws; it's right there.
Right.
So I said, "Okay, register." So I registered, and it was really simple. It was really simple. I registered, and within, she had her food handlers, and within 5 days, we had the certificate.
But we started the next day. We started posting everything online, pictures, and using Facebook, using different things.
Speaking of pictures, let me show folks what pictures, because I want to show them. Here's a picture of your, well, that's a video. Where did I put the pictures? I am so good at this. I'm going to show the video in a minute, but I wanted to show this this photo first. Let me pull this up real quick. Here's a close-up of the cookie, okay? I know that's covering the screen up a little bit. I'll cover me up with it there. So I look good as a cookie. So I was hoping that these were going to look this good, because I had seen these cookies before you sent them to me. And I saw this picture, and I was like, oh, man, because it looks soft. It looks buttery and delicious, and it is. And now it's been, I don't know how many days it took for it to get to me, and then it's been a day since I got them, now 2 days, because they came yesterday morning. Apparently, I didn't get them till last night out of the mailbox. And they're soft. They're soft. They're still soft. So they're not stale cookies. They're nice, soft, juicy cookies. So what can you tell people about this? I know you're not going to give your recipe.
No, I won't. I will not give up the recipe.
I don't blame
you. But there's certain techniques how you bake them. There's certain ingredients that you add to them. There's no preservatives. There's nothing like that in them. So when you get them, they're going to be fresh. They're going to stay fresh. I'm actually, like, for our shipping, we have actually ordered bags, and I thought they'd be here by now, but they're not. So always order ahead of time for your holiday baking send-outs. But they're going to be in these little bags, and literally in these bags, you can throw them in your freezer and keep them for a year. Easy. And then that right there that you're showing, those are great. Those are what I do deliveries locally. And if you keep them in those bags right there, those are good for 2 weeks, but they're not going to last that long. So
no, yeah. No, nobody with a cow or a grocery store that has milk is going to freaking let those sit on the counter long. those are amazing, amazing cookies. I've baked a Blue Million, and every time, I don't have a favorite chocolate chip cookie recipe, so every time I go to make one, I just Google and make some chocolate chip cookies, because I've never found one that is like, boom. So I'm impressed, Dee. Really good. Really good. So so if y'all want cookies, if you want a cookie, you want to try a cookie, go to learnhotdogs.com/Dee. I just created a pretty link, basically. You're not going to Learn Hot Dogs, really. That's going to take you to their eBay listing directly. And that way you can grab you 3 dozen of delicious cookies. And I'd like to show that. Let me see if that pulls up. No, it doesn't. So let me go back over to here. And now I'll try it again. I'm a professional. So there's their listing. You can buy 3 dozen. And free shipping, and try them out. And then try to figure out the recipe from your tryouts. Good luck with that. So anyway, what's next? What do y'all see next happening? And is it doing well on Facebook?
It is. That is the first day we were like, wow, what's going on here? I guess I was right. We can sell these. What we did was, I have a Twitter account. I have an Instagram. I have a Pinterest, and I have a Facebook, and we belong to several groups here in the area, and we're getting a lot of orders off of the groups.
How are you marketing? How are you marketing though, Jim, to the group? How do you put that out there?
Well, a very detailed with the picture like you show there. We actually have 3 or 4 pictures with the packaging and everything. I put that in there with a long spiel, not a long spiel, just a detailed spiel, because, you know, people need to be informed how much they are, a dozen, where they can pick up at.
Or have delivered.
We get their address. We get their phone number. They can text or call her and put their order in. They can pre-order also for coming days, which we have several of those right now. But that's basically it. And they say, well, I'd like them at 11 o'clock. Well, we'll be there at 11 o'clock, and I roll up.
My delivery boy.
You know, looking good like I do, you know. I charge a delivery fee. The delivery fee and that for local here is $5. And I'll tell you a quick side note. The first day, an elderly gentleman, he ordered 4 dozen, and he lived on the other side of town. We got the order together. Of course, we were ecstatic, you know, right? 4 dozen. Okay. So I ran him over to him. He was sitting in his driveway all by himself in a chair. And I swear to you, he was tapping his foot. He got out of that chair, walked up to me. I said, would you like me to put my mask on, sir? He said, no, you're not going to be here that long. Give me my cookies. And the delivery fee was $5. He paid me for the cookies, and he tipped me $5 also.
And then within 10 minutes before Jim was even home, the man sent me a text, said, these are the best cookies I have ever had.
Dang.
And I loved it.
Dang. I'm happiness. You can't beat that.
Uh-uh.
No. Well, the happiness, you see, you know, and she's so happy.
I am.
You know, I think that's part of it, too, is doing what you like and having some passion. And she really does. And just seeing the people's faces, though, and the text messages. The one lady ordered, she had a group meeting with a bunch of people at a clubhouse in a condo. I pulled up, gave her 3 dozen cookies. She's reordered twice since then.
Holy cow. So let me give y'all a tip. And you may know this, Jim. You may have heard me say this before on a video. But I want to tell you something about organic always does better. And it, you know, I saw your ad, and I'm going to put that back up here so people can see it. But here's their ad, one of the ads they posted. This one was their first ad, I believe, right? This ad that I just posted up.
Let me take a close up.
We gotta get close up.
Sorry, folks. I'm not trying to be in your face. Yes, it does. It does look that way, Ben, for sure. Okay.
So, these kinds of things, I call it an ad, even though you're not paying for it. You're posting up a promotion for yourself. Organic promotions work better, and I want to tell you, if you have friends and family, that you can have post some stuff up in these groups, your local groups, that says, oh my gosh, with a picture of a glass of milk and the cookie close up, doesn't even have to be them. Oh my gosh, best cookie I've ever had, got it in the mail yesterday. Don't even tell them where. They post it in a group. What's going to happen is everybody in the group's going to go, where'd they get them? Where'd you get them? Where'd you get them? And that's where you come in, and you watch that post, and you start going, oh, they got them from us. We're local, so we can deliver, or if you need them shipped, we'll ship them. And you will get more business than you know what to do with. I've done this with several cottage fooders already. I just helped a local business, friends of ours that have a produce stand. That, well, it's a produce building, but they do produce. It's a produce, fresh produce market. And they try to source locally. And the owner died. They bought it. They're a younger couple, kind of, and they've struggled because nobody had any loyalty to it once the owner was gone, and they're not kin to the owner. So I started posting up me, just a random guy in our local groups that, oh, my gosh, you got to check this out. I just got this, made this with it, got it over here. And because our local group, our biggest local group on Facebook, doesn't allow you to advertise, but it ain't my company. So I can mention them 85 times a day if I want. I don't, but I mention them at least once a day. Well, their business has exploded. And when I say exploded, it is boom. They hired more employees because they can't keep up. I mentioned spaghetti squash one day. And they sold out that day, and they had a truck, like a pallet that had come on a truck with one of those huge cardboard boxes that you could get inside of, loaded to the top with spaghetti squash. It all disappeared that day because I showed one freaking recipe. And it wasn't my recipe. I got it off allrecipes.com, but I made it at my house, took a picture, and said, oh, my gosh, these are the best spaghetti squash in the world. And people were like, where'd you get it? Well, good thing you brought that up. Anyway, I have had fun using those kinds of tactics that are more real. People love sharing stuff. Like, they want to be in the know. People love being in the know. So if you can share stuff like that, it's great. Now, I've got two videos y'all sent me, and I want to share those in a minute. But I want to go through some of the comments. For whatever reason, I'm not able to jack the comments up onto the screen. I did find them, but whatever I try doesn't put them up there. So, let's see. Richard Paul says, she must be the cookie queen, and that smile tells it all. Congratulations, guys. Kay Garrison says, I need your recipe. MA had cottage laws before there were cottage laws. They mandate home kitchen inspections. Yes, home kitchen inspections are common in some states. Not a big deal. Move on. If you've seen Dee's kitchen, it's freaking spotless. Spotless. Let's see. Each state is different. Absolutely, Lewis. Lewis is in our Vendors United group, and you probably know that. But he serves all kinds of stuff. Each state is different, and I can help you find stuff if you need help finding something about your cottage food laws. Just send me an email and I'll help you. I am creating a new website, but it ain't out yet. It ain't going to be out till around the 24th of this month. That'll help you find it. It'll be a free website, updated constantly with any rule changes, law changes, everything. And it'll be interpreted. I've interpreted the legalese into hillbillyese. And so it's going to be twice as hard to understand, but you'll understand. Look up Food Cottage Act in your state. Absolutely. Oh, my God, I'm so craving chocolate right now. Don't have a bit in the house. LOL. Steve Bivens says that. Okay, Lewis, this is a different Lewis. What was the first thing you did to start?
The first thing I did was after seeing what you had posted, look up our cottage laws here. That was the very first thing. And within 15 minutes of looking it up and knowing what we needed to do, Jim was already on it, already submitted for it, and we were approved. I mean, it took a few days for the certificate to arrive, but we were approved right away because we had everything already in line.
Awesome. We already had our food handler certificate from doing your hot dogs and buying your hot dog cart. The food handler certificate is good for 5 years. Is that correct?
Well, for the one we have.
The one we have is for 5 years.
Yeah.
All right. So, another one was after we just talked about the social media, Blake asked, how has it been working on social media for you, marketing, et cetera? How's that work? Has it worked out okay?
Yeah, it's working out really good. And I wanted to add to what you said because it was important. I like what you said about, and we have some good friends here. We have some really, really good friends here where we live. We live in a community, a gated community, and they love the cookies. And a friend of hers, actually, the very first thing we did goes back to what you said, Ben. Yeah. We reached out to her and asked her if she would do us a favor and put a post up with the same language that you said, oh my gosh, I'm glad she's selling these now. And nice. That was very, very helpful. And we also have one other friend in the community that is selling to die for cinnamon rolls. And she's doing the same thing, taking our lead. I don't want to say that, but we're real happy for them and they are delicious. So again, kind of paying it forward, people seeing that they can do that. You can do this.
Yes.
That is freaking awesome. Folks, if you're wondering what the hell this is, homebakingprofits.com. I explain it all to you. A teacher that was out of work back in, I think that happened in March or April. I put that out about her. She's still kicking butt with it. We'll never go back to teaching because she's making more money doing this from her kitchen in an apartment than she is with was with teaching. This one says, Joey says, working class geniuses. Kim says, I'm driving to Phoenix right now from Montana listening live.
Nice.
Let's see. I'm just making sure I don't have questions. Way too cool, Ben. Love that idea. Let's see. Oh, David says the cookies are even better when they're free. Well, I agree that free stuff's good, but I've had people give me stuff that I wouldn't touch.
That sounds like my brother.
Somebody, Lewis says kettle corn has done well for him through the Texas food cottage law. If you want to know what all this is, go to Home Baking Profits. I explained it all there. And you can check it out. anyway, that rooster was my phone.
It's a great course, folks. I just wanted to say that, Ben, out loud. It is a good course. There's so many things that I've learned from you over the years that has really helped us. And the other thing I wanted to mention, you asked what we want to do going forward. We're going to build a website. We are selling on eBay right now. But the other thing is, you have a, like I said earlier, you did this interview with Bob on the State Fair Mini Donuts. Ours is coming tomorrow.
Freaking awesome. So you're going to be doing from home, you're going to be doing donuts as an option.
Yes.
And you're going to love the freaking donuts. You're going to have so much fun with that little machine. Grab extra milk because you're going to need it. Michael Petro says, do you got milk for them cookies? And then Clarificness says, woot, woot, bring on the moo juice. David says, I've been anxiously awaiting this interview all day. Let's see. A warm cookie would be good right now from David Colvard. Robbie says, who's got cookies? if you want to order cookies, you know what? Have fun. Order them. Try them. And you'll see why people are ordering from them. It's not, this isn't magic. This is, you can make real money. And you can, yes. I've helped friends and family. Some of them too lazy to get out of their own damn way. Start cottage food because, oh, I can watch TV and cook and just sell. I ain't got to do nothing. Yeah, you can do that. It is still work. And if you see Dee's kitchen, it's clean. Okay. There's things you want to do right. You want to, every now and then when you post, you know, Jim may want to take a picture of Dee baking with her gloves on or something so that it shows how clean everything is. That, you know what? I'm going to show that video real quick. Let's do that.
And she's using her gloves. Everything is done with her gloves on.
And everything's always sanitized. That's huge to me. That's important. I want somebody to cook for me like that.
And we ship priority mail 2 to 4 days.
And see, that's brilliant. By showing it, it helps people relieve them. Because my wife is one of those that the first thing she said with these cookies was, do you know them?
Right.
Like, do they have 17 cats that live on the kitchen counter? And
right.
And those things people worry about from home food businesses, you know, cottage food companies. So Dee's video right here. Let me play this one.
Hi, everybody. I just want to give you a little, for instance, of what I do here with these delicious cookies. Basically, I start my day and I prepackage all my dry mixes together. And that way, when it's time to start really cooking, all I have to do is dump in a bowl, mix it, add my couple other little ingredients, and I'm ready to go. So it makes it really quick, easy, and efficient. That way everything is nice, clean, and neat. And then after I get my dough ready, I go and I throw all my chocolate chips in this bad boy. And oh boy, these are gonna be good.
That looks good.
All right, now they're ready for oven.
Now, how do you resist that kind of stuff? I'm going to show this other video real quick. Here's their packaging video.
Okay, well, they're hot, out of the oven, ready to go. Once they do cool, I place them in this bag. It's a very sealable bag. This bag will last 2 weeks with these cookies. So, and then the other ones, I'll have individual for shipping. Those last up to a year. So I just want to show you, very important. Make sure you follow your state's cottage laws. Very important. And always have this up and hanging. Very visible for anybody who walks in. Appreciate you.
All right. So that I appreciate you doing that, those videos and sharing them with us all. Do y'all see how clean her kitchen is? You can tell she's anal retentive about that, like my wife is.
She is.
My wife sanitizes everything. She sanitizes the sanitizer. I mean, she's and so you have to be clean. And if people know that you're clean and you that it gives them confidence to order. Some people won't care, but other people will. People will. That will be a stumbling block for them. Somebody mentioned on here just a second ago while the video was playing about they can't ship from their state. They're not allowed to ship out of state. Most states do not allow you to ship out of state. Don't worry about it. There's plenty of business in state, okay? I don't care where you live. You could live in Wyoming. There's plenty of business there. You're not trying to become an Amazon of cottage food. So just focus on your local area and do delivery. Some states allow you to have it like Uber Eats. They allow you to deliver it that way. So, and it doesn't have to be cookies. There's a blue million things you can do legally from your home kitchen. So keep those in mind. Is anyone doing this from Georgia? Absolutely. We have people in our Vendors United group doing it in Georgia. Let's see. Michigan allows you to bake cookies from home. Yes, they Michigan allows several lots of foods from home.
Yes, they do.
I have some things to do.
Let's see. It's Christmas time, a wonderful time to make some delicious cookies. Remember, not everyone knows how to cook. Absolutely. That is a good point. You may not know how to cook. Stick to something easy then. Okay, do something easy from your house. So guess what you can do? And this is just a magical tip for you. Let's say you want to do awesome rolls, yeast rolls or whatever, but you don't know how to cook, and yeast rolls are finicky. Okay, buy them suckers. Buy the most expensive yeast roll dough that you can get from one of the broadline distributors. Okay, even Sam's Clubs in some places sells it. It's already in dough balls. You let it rise and you oven it. Now you're selling your own. And if you want to, rub a little butter on top of it when it comes out of the oven, and now it's 100% your own. Okay? Now you can sell it as my yeast rolls. I bake these right here in my home kitchen. Okay? So there's ways around it. You can make cake. There's easy mixes that you can do and easy lessons online for how, for somebody cooking for dummies, no joke. They have a book called Cooking for Dummies, Baking for Dummies. So you can do this. I've self-taught myself how to cook, and I still screw up a lot, but I have a blast doing it. So you don't have to be a master. You don't have to have the best oven in the world. In fact, some states prohibit you from having commercial equipment. So they want to inspire you to go commercial, but they're allowing you to do it from a residence legally. And that's what Jim and Dee are doing here, and you ought to be doing too. And especially if you go to church or something, or you got a group you're with or your friends, and you've got some family member or somebody you know who goes, man, I need income. I've got daughters right now. I've got one daughter right now that was a school teacher, lost her job, COVID, okay? And she's doing this. Been doing this since about June, roughly June. She's making a freaking living from sending out food from her home. So
it's a great story.
This too. I love it. I love the opportunity. And even if it's not your cup of tea, you don't gonna do it forever. This is a stepping block to further up. Tell us something else, Jim and Dee.
Again, along with what you're saying, I think the biggest thing that I like about all this right now is because of the times we're in. I know we've been talking about this for a long time, and it looks like we're going to be doing it for a little while longer. I just think there's so many people out there right now, like you said, maybe it's the single father and his son, maybe it's the single mother and her daughter, and you know they're looking for some extra income. You can do this, and I just, you know, Ben has so many teachings out there, and I'm not just trying to prop him up.
No.
You know,
no,
I love
him. Please do. But,
you know, you should really read and see his videos, and he can show you a lot. And he's inspired me over the last couple of years, and we've done really well with things you've had to say. And also, we were talking about the packaging. I wanted to mention that. About our cottage law here. I know I'm going off track, but
no, this is what it's about.
So our packaging, let me see, our packaging, of course, those look real nice and everything, but you're also required, and what she does, she makes her own labels. You are required to have the ingredients, and she has the ingredients on which way?
You're so opposite.
On the bottom.
Go back. There you go.
Okay. So she puts the labels on there with the ingredients. And, you know, the cookies are just fantastic. And just, again, watching these people being happy and reordering. I mean, I met the lady out front earlier today, and she's getting vegan cookies, which I'm not crazy about. But, you know, she got them, and she said, Merry Christmas. Thank you so much. And she's texting my wife, and I'm only a block away telling her how delicious they are. So it's fun. It's fun, too. And I like to see people happy, but a lot of people can do this, and I would love for a lot more people to do this if they so choose.
That's freaking awesome. Let me read you some comments. Let's see. Luz says Philadelphia doesn't allow the cottage food law. Yes, they do. We got vendors there doing it. And it's legal. I've looked up that one. Let's see. Next one. Genius to show you in action. Next step is to show your product in action. Videos of someone eating as enjoying every crumb. That's a good one. That was from Richard Paul. Veronica says, awesome. Congratulations. Many people eat with their eyes. That's from Luis Martinez in Texas. Jim and Dee, I love success stories. I really appreciate the both of you taking your time to go over this with us. A big hearty thank you, David Gregory. Brian Pierce says, yes, clean. I love clean. Let's see. Ray says, retirement from working for others, open Sonoran hot dog smash burger can't. Cart and snacks and catering. Wife has own cookie recipe, originally Tucson and now in San Antonio, Texas. Thanks, Ben, for the knowledge. Let's see. Do y'all wholesale? Bob asks, do you wholesale? Now, you know who Bob is, right?
I do. I do. I haven't even thought about that yet, but that's a good idea.
You mean after an entire week in business?
Come on now. I know. We'll catch up.
That's hilarious. And I'm really stoked about getting this mini donut oven tomorrow and the donuts. And yeah, I'm really excited about that.
So Ben, another thought that's been crossing my mind as well, along with my cookies, is actually creating tubs eventually and selling the tubs so they can just take and bake.
Now, that is a great idea. Some states don't allow you to do raw product, especially if it has egg in it. And I assume your cookies have an egg or 10.
They do, but I can also switch that out a little bit for the take and bakes.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, you could use the artificial eggs.
No.
No? Okay. I'm not even going to ask anymore. Is there anyone in Florida does this? Yes, there's lots of people in Florida do the Cottage Act, including my sister, one of my sisters who I've written about. With the kettle corn. She's doing kettle corn through the Cottage Food Act. And just to let you know, if you're in Florida, Florida's one of the easiest states in the world, okay? Yeah. Florida makes it so easy. They're like, oh, you want to start a cottage food? Yeah, just start it. Is there a license? No. Do you need to sign up or any? Nope. Just do it.
Yeah.
Have fun. And you'll love Florida. If you need any help looking anything up on Florida, let me know, and I'll hook you up. Let's see. Use this money from cookies to earn the money to buy you a cart. Hot dogs and sausages have a big profit margin. Art, make peace, has said that one. And he's right. So, Oklahoma farm gal. I've been looking up the Oklahoma food cottage laws, and they are easy. That is true. I have been all the way from top to bottom of everything Oklahoma. And you're right, it is easy. Waiting to get my donut maker. Now I'm considering adding cookies and cupcakes. Absolutely.
Yes.
Let's see. Check out Lovable Sweets in Toledo, Ohio for your holiday needs. There's a plug. I accidentally plugged someone I don't even know about. So how to find them is go to learnhotdogs.com/D. David Gregory. Ben, your knowledge and insight are a brilliant spotlight in a murky cloud of innuendo and conjecture. You know what, David, I just wing it. I'm it's like standing on the backs of giants. Somebody famous once said that about when they were given some award. They said, yeah, I was standing on the backs of giants because all these scientists came before them. And it was about a science deal. But I am thankful because of people like Jim and Dee who share their stories. I'm allowed to push those out. And I learn every time. I learn different stuff. Like I just learned, I didn't learn the secret, but I learned from Dee that there's a way to put out these eggs in cookies in a raw form. So I'm looking forward to knowing that one. Ron says, why did you stop the hot dog cart? Do you mind just, you don't have to go into much detail there, but.
Sure. To be honest with you, we actually started the hot dog cart business in Florida. It was my next business venture, and I spent 12 hours one night watching Ben. That's honest truth. I spent 12 hours watching this man, learning all I could learn because I wanted to get the hot dog business. We did it for a year there. We were very successful. I had all the licensing, everything I was supposed to do. We vended at huge baseball tournaments, making $1,500 a day. I mean, nonstop. What stopped us was we had some family issues. And it's okay. I don't mind sharing. My mother had been sick for quite a while, and we were going back and forth, and it was wearing us out financially. We were going back to Tennessee, and we just finally had to fold. But you know what? The past is the past, and we're here now. And you know, we have that. We work good together, and you know, this is going to be good too.
I think it's going to be awesome. So hopefully that answered your question. Bottom line, family issues, and sold it and moved, and now lives in Arizona after taking care of his mom and Dee, her mother-in-law. So awesome. It was a brilliant decision. And it took you how long to sell your hot dog cart in Florida?
2 days. And I got almost what I paid for it.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
So, I love it. Let's see. Sometimes it's hard to see the forest because of all the trees in the way. Great advice, David. Okay, Marty Woodley says, my city told me I needed a business or to own a house to sell what I was making. That is untrue, Marty. Here's the deal. You will often hear crap that is untrue. Not that they're trying to lie to you. It's just because somebody's told them some crap and they took it as true. Like somebody that trained them told them, or maybe they heard it somewhere at a bar. Drunk lady told them, and so they spread that and thought it was true, or they had a bad dream one night and thought it up. The bottom line is, I have an article on how to do that with diplomacy to find out the truth. Always ask for proof, and you don't have to go, well, you're going to have to prove that to me. All you have to do is say, hey, I'm new at this. Could you help me? Where is that in the code? Because if it ain't in the code, they can't enforce it. If it ain't in the code, they can't enforce it. If you need help with that, go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. Okay? It'll help you use diplomacy to find out real answers. What is a vegan cookie, Brian Pierce asked? Okay. Does that even exist?
Vegan cookie can contain no dairy whatsoever. So no eggs, no milk chocolate, semi-sweet chocolate. No butter. So basically, you know, you got to switch up your semi-sweets for dark chocolates. And they will say vegan, that they're vegan on them. And then other things that I use that I don't disclose. But but they are true vegan. There's no dairy whatsoever involved in these. So a vegan, no meat, no dairy. Period.
She's already prepared some for her daughter is coming actually Sunday. And her daughter is vegan, 100%. And so she could not give her daughter a not vegan product because she would know. She's like a hound dog. She would know.
My daughter, her name is Jemima, the one that won't eat anything. Have y'all had meat in the house in the last week or two? Because I smell meat. Anyway, I tell her no. But now when she asks to come visit, I go, we're not even going to be in town. So I'm just kidding. But her name is Jemima. She's one of the girls we adopted, and she's freaking brilliant, and she's cocky and sarcastic, which I love. This is a great question. I love these good questions. Mike Fent asks, how did you go from making the first cookie to finding someone to buy it? I don't know how to get the word out or the advertising, the way to do it properly that first time to start it. Because sometimes that is the barrier. Yes, I can make cookies. Now what? It's kind of like my video. I got a hot dog cart. Now what? That video?
Yeah. Remember that one?
Yeah.
you make that cookie, you take a picture, you post it. Or just like we had our friend, if she's on here, maybe early, posted it for us. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad my friend started selling these cookies. It's about time. And she had pictures of the cookie and posted it. And that's where things started taking off. So once that took off, little bit by little bit, people would post, make comments. I'd jump in. And then I started creating, I use Marketplace. Marketplace is huge because anything in your area that you've already joined the groups on, Marketplace, you just hit those extra groups on top of that. And it takes them to all of the groups. So nobody's going to miss it if they're on any of the groups.
And she's right about that. The Facebook Marketplace, and then when you put something on Facebook Marketplace, if you belong to a bunch of groups, you can share it to that. And then it gives you the option to share to all these other groups. The other important thing is to answer his question a little bit, pictures. You've got to take good pictures.
Good pictures.
The one lady made a comment. How does that go? A picture is like being there and eating it or whatever. I can't come up. Yeah, like look at that.
Yum.
We've got so many comments on just that picture alone.
I told my wife, I said,
split it open, honey. Split it open. Let them see the gooiness.
and don't ever use pictures you found online. Okay.
Nope. Use your own.
Use your own pictures. And even a slow-mo 11-second video with your phone close up of you opening a cookie or a piece of bread or whatever you're baking for your business goes a long ways.
That's a great idea.
I'm taking it.
Well, do you know there's a whole group of people that it's a whole group, like it's a fetish, but not, I hate to use the word fetish because it sounds, sexual. But, like people that like feet, these people like sounds of things up close. And there's a name for it, and I can't think of it. Maybe somebody will tell me in here. But you take a cookie up close, and you have no sound around you, and you open that cookie, and they hear that chocolate and everything just. And it's a thing. It's a psychological thing that people love. I love it. I may have it. I don't know if there's a pill for it, but I don't even care about it. Hadn't caused me any problems. I haven't lost my license over it.
She's over here tapping me on my shoulder. My shoulder's getting sore. She goes, Jim, we got to do that. The video.
I'm on it.
The do it up close. And there's tons of little ideas like this that will grow you and keep going and keep going. Wesley, ask any info on South Carolina. Wesley, let me say this real quick. I am building a new website that'll be free to everybody. It's going to cover every state's rules. I'm almost done with it. It has been a labor of love for a long freaking time. And by the time I get done, there's some states that have already had some updates because of COVID that changed their codes to make it easier to get into the business. One just did it in October. So just 2 months ago, they changed the rules to make it easier. So I am getting everything done, and I will be putting that out. Can you find a used donut oven? There is a website that we talk about on Vendors United all the time. I don't remember the name of it, but you can find used equipment. Here's what you need to find, though. It's not going to be called a donut oven. Just hint, hint. It's going to be called a toaster oven. Okay? A bread toaster. It's conveyor belt bread toaster. You can find them dirt cheap on used restaurant supply places. If you will email me, Keith Rigdon said, That was Keith Rigdon. I will find that link for you. It's an auction place of used restaurant equipment in the country, and you can get dirt cheap stuff, dirt cheap. So, Joey's in Florida listening. Bob Rusky, Bobaruno says powdered egg. I guess that was to the, it's not powdered egg. Nothing no. like making money doing what you love, Alex says. I plan to start up baking shop in Oklahoma. What would you suggest for me? Rick, I would suggest whatever you love. Don't try to be everything to everybody. Don't try to have 18 things on your menu at first. Go with something you are good at or you practice and become good at, but pick one or two items and just stick with that for now. They're a week in, so once you get way, way in like they are in a week, then you go to donuts with your cookies. So,
like that.
But keep it simple. Seriously, keep it simple.
Torsha says, oh, I'm so excited about this. David Clark says, happy for my little brother and his DD.
That's my brother.
I love it.
Thanks for the shout out.
That gave me chill bumps. I got brothers. I like that. That just shows love, man. Let's see. Augusta says, I watched so many of your videos. You have me so excited. I'm so glad I joined VU. This is awesome. Happy holidays, Ben and Jim and Dee's. Thank you for making a difference in 2020. That was awesome. Thank you for the kind words. Alex says, my mom and I love baking, and eventually with the profits I make from doing this, I want to open a bakery to honor my mom. Freaking chill bumps. Look at this. Look at my hair stand up.
Beautiful.
I love stuff like that. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that, Alex. Law Dogs. I just seen this video with the young couple. They started the donut business that you posted. Awesome, Law Dogs. Isn't that cool? I just posted at learnhotdogs.com that couple that started their kettle corn business from their kitchen. Through the Cottage Food Act, and they gave everything they did to get started. Augusta says, congratulations, you guys, on your business. Blake says, how about Texas? Hey, Lewis is in here. He's in Texas doing it now with kettle corn. Texas is easy. I'd like to sell tamales. Tamales may be trickier, and depending on your state, it may still be doable from a home kitchen. But it probably ain't. So maybe try something different. California does allow it, though. California allow tamales. They have variations on their cottage food laws.
It seems like a lot, what I read about the cottage law in Arizona, I, without going into detail, but what the reading I did, a lot of it is confection type stuff. I didn't see like a lot of, I didn't see any meat, no meat. You know, so,
anything that has to be refrigerated.
Yeah. Right. Except some states do. In my studies so far, there's been a few states that do allow meat and do allow refrigeration on cottage food. David says, my goodness, these guys won't let anything stop them. Another stellar success story.
Thank you.
Let's see. Christy says hi from Asheville, North Carolina. Blue Mountain Steaming Dogs and Catering. I love that name. Blue Mountain Steaming. I've never heard of this. This is Kay Garrison says, when you start making donuts, look into making donut walls. Maybe holes?
Donut holes?
Maybe holes.
It says walls, so I don't know. And they even have a picture of a donut, but... Kay Garrison says, do cookie bouquets. Valentine's Day.
That's nice. That's
beautiful,
a good one.
Actually.
I like that idea.
Thanks, Kay.
Yeah. You could really put the guilt level on some dudes around February. Man.
That's a great idea.
How many marriages you'll save with your cookies, D?
How many marriages would you say?
Oh, now, come on now. I'm not a miracle worker.
We aren't able to run our hot dog cart right now. Causing us being open a cart is what we are told, and even got us a vendor canopy and still say we can't operate. Christy, this may be an opportunity for you. You probably can operate your hot dog cart at some private locations. If you're in VU, you'll hear us talking about vendors doing hospitals. Hospitals are hiring vendors to come there with their carts and prepaying them to feed the employees. And that makes them an essential worker because they close the cafeterias in these hospitals in these red states right now. When I say red, it's not about Republican. I'm saying red states as far as COVID cases, which is pretty much all of them right now. Robbie says no cottage laws in New Jersey. Guess what, Robbie? Out of the 50 states, or if you ask my wife, it's 52 because Hawaii and Alaska. Cottage, that's New Jersey is the only one that has not adopted cottage food. I do expect it to happen. And the reason I expect it is because of COVID. It's going to help a lot of people survive when they've lost jobs or they do another shutdown or anything. There are ways to do other things, Robbie. And if you'll email me, I'll help you. So let's see. Mike says that was an awesome picture. Now I'm hungry. Excellent information. Oh, Greg Crafton's in the house, and he shared the link to where you get those cheap deals on equipment, proxybid.com. Hey, for you that are listening, though, just in case you missed it before, learnhotdogs.com/D, you'll see it right below me here, okay, is a direct link to a eBay page where they're selling. They'll ship you. I don't care if you're in Alaska. They will ship you some freaking cookies that D made right there in that room where they are right now.
We will.
So, let's see. From Mississippi listening, somebody says something about my stupid dimples. Fixing to join. I have to read these first because some of them I could, get me in trouble. Hardy, thank you for everything you do on the behalf. We just see it. Okay, Ben Hardy, thank you for everything that you do on our behalf. We just see the end result, but most of us have no idea about the amount of work that goes into making all these videos, interviews. You know what? I haven't even had to do the hard part here. They agreed to do this. Dee was a little bit hesitant because she's shy, okay? But how freaking awesome is it? She looks way better than her husband on camera, that's for sure. He's like me. He's got a face for radio. And I do too. I do too. Okay. So thank you for it's people like this that are willing to come on because you can bet I ask a lot of people. I have a lot of people send me testimonials and I go, hey, you want to come on? Well, I asked Jim and Jim goes, sure. I don't even think he told you yet. And Jamie asked a great question. Jamie's in our VU group. Jamie says, any special prep for shipping? Like, do you do anything? Is there something you do to make sure they're cared for?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. What we do is after, the cookies come out and they cool, I flash freeze them overnight. And then I wrap them and seal them. And then we ship them. So they have to be flash frozen first.
Okay.
That way, when they get to you, they're soft, they're ready to go.
How are you flash freezing?
Deep freezer.
Okay.
Boom.
Okay.
Overnight.
Okay.
And we set yours that way, Ben.
Okay.
Yours were frozen when you got them. Okay. I mean, when we set yours, we set them frozen.
Okay. Well, they had thawed out, but it was cold enough to keep them frozen in my mailbox because it was below freezing here that day, yesterday.
Yeah.
But not not today they wouldn't have. But I'm sure in between in somebody's warm USPS truck, they thawed out.
Yeah. Well, and what's nice about them too is at room temperature, like she said earlier, They're good for 2 weeks.
You wouldn't have known they had been frozen. Like, there was no moisture droplets. There was no goo. Like, I've frozen cookies before, and there's some goo. There was no goo.
Yeah, and I shipped out four packages today. Two went to Michigan, one went to Wisconsin, and one went to Florida, I think.
That is freaking awesome, and that's gonna only get busier. hey, y'all can help. Go to learnhotdogs.com/D, and you can order you 3 dozen freaking delicious. I have some. Okay, now I've picked up this bag about 8 times and dropped it. But I have beautiful cookies. I should have showed them the prettier ones. They're almost gone. They sent me a dump truck load of cookies, and they're delicious. My wife loves them. I love them. They're still soft. That's what I don't know how you get that to stay, because I've bought cookies. Unless you go buy some crap from like Chips Ahoy, they're soft cookie, they're chewy cookie. But then it's chewy, and it's almost like sourdough bread chewy. And I don't really care for that. I like a cookie to taste like it came out of the oven. Joey said this is going to be better than a fruit basket.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, Joey's right. Her family recipe, like I said, spent a long time, and I've been eating these for years, and my sons, everybody just always like, the first thing they say is, how delicious are these things?
They're freaking unreal. And so that'd make a great gift for somebody, even for Christmas. That may be some ideas to put out there. Hey, we'll send cookies anywhere you want. Send somebody delicious cookies. Kind of like Harry and David's does, but not for the $95 price tag.
Right.
And you get three cookies in a really pretty box.
Yeah.
I'd rather have the 3 dozen in an ugly box.
Believe me, you're going to love these delicious cookies. And we do appreciate the support and the outpouring of messages and how everybody's happy. We really appreciate the support. We did want to say that.
Yeah. Jay Bryan says, we had a Spud Nuts donut wall at our wedding. See, that's the second time, this donut wall. I don't know what that is.
We need to find out.
I know. We need to find out.
I bet Google knows. I'll go to YouTube University or something and find out. Been eating those cookies since I was a kid. They are amazing. I love you guys. Kayla.
Yes. Yes.
Brian says it's a wall of donuts.
Wow.
I have a small wall of bourbon, but I have never thought about a wall of donuts. Sounds good. Kay Garrison says it's called a donut wall. Look it up. It's very profitable.
Okay.
I'm going to look it up too. Do you see what I'm talking about? You keep learning. Everybody keeps learning. Check this out. I thought about messaging people doing yard sales on weekends to bring them my lemonade stand. That's a great idea. You're going to find so many people like car dealers when y'all are busy that just want to rent your machine for the day and 800 donuts. And it's so easy to operate, you know, a squirrel can do it.
Don't get me excited, Ben.
let's see. Combo of cookies and donuts that y'all can start doing, Bob says. Posey just said, I just ordered 3 dozen.
We appreciate that very much.
Thank you.
You're going to love them. They're going to be delicious.
Good. Marcus says, you're right. Bake it from scratch. You can cater weddings. Lewis says, start working for Valentine's now. Valentine's heart-shaped box with cookies. You will make a killing. Look at them on Etsy. It's a wall full of donuts. Back to the donut thing. I still don't understand that concept. Like, when I think of a wall, I think sheetrock, not donuts.
I'm going to check it out.
Yeah, me too. Anyway, do y'all have anything you want to add before we go? We've already been on an hour. And so.
Yeah. We just want to thank you, Ben. You know, we love you, brother, man. I we appreciate everything you do.
Thank you.
We really do. And I've learned so much. You provided so much information over so many years and put in the work and the effort, and you've helped us. You have helped us. And we just want to this to be not just about us. We're grateful for this, but I hope going into next year, if there are people out there and you're looking for a way, you got to look at this. You got to look at this and be passionate about it. If you're good at making cookies and you think, you know what?
Cakes or
whatever, and you're like, I can sell these. Well, by gosh, do it. And that's really all I can say.
You need to jump in and don't be afraid.
It's
scary, but jump in and do it anyway. And you're gonna be surprised.
I love it. I love that you did it and that you shared so much. I really appreciate the fact that you'd give us this much time and share it. I do want to add to your point about do anything. For about 3 months, I've been trying to get a lady to do an interview. She's a single mom. She did bagels. She knew how to do bagels from her grandmother. She's been shipping bagels and she can't ship out of state. So she ships local, interstate. And, and I'm sure some sneak over the line sometimes, but either way, who's going to know, right?
Right.
Hell, they ship marijuana out of state.
Forget.
As soon as Colorado legalized it, everybody in the country was getting marijuana packages.
Yeah.
Anyway, lots of thank yous in the group that people are putting in these chats. Thank y'all so much for watching. I know it was a long one, but well worth it. I enjoyed it. Thank y'all again for sharing the videos, the tips. Sending me free cookies. I thank you a ton, and I'm probably gonna have you ship some of those to somebody I care about, and maybe the gluten ones to Jemima, maybe.
We'll do it.
Vegan ones, yes.
Yeah, vegan, whatever. Yeah.
Vegan.
I get it all mixed up. Vegan, vegetarian, and they change weekly what they're doing, you know.
We've appreciated everybody's support and watching this tonight too. And thank you for all the nice comments. We really appreciate it. It makes us feel good.
It really does. Thank you all very much. And happy holidays to everybody.
Awesome. Thank you. Let me tell you this before you go. Go to learnhotdogs.com/D. That will not take you to Learn Hot Dogs. That will take you directly to D's Delicious Cookies on eBay, where you can get them if you're out of state. If you're in state, that you can find them on Facebook. Also, homebakingprofits.com if you want to get in the business of making something. Bagels, cakes, sourdough bread, all kinds of stuff. Some states allow up to like 90 different items, categories of items, in their state from your home kitchen legally. Some states require no licensing. So you can start today. You'll find that at homebakingprofits.com. I look forward to hearing all the success stories that come from this, because you know that's what's going to happen next, is people are going to hear about this. You kind of heard about this watching Bob's video on the donuts.
Yeah.
So I wish you all the best. Thank you so much for coming on and doing this. And
thank you, Ben.
I love you both. And I appreciate it a bunch.
We love you too, Ben. Thank you so much.
See you.